decide it would be, as a committee, as a board, you wanted to discuss it?
Well, there was my request about the liaison to the department.
Mr. Chair, my understanding is it was the coordination meeting that we had with WISE, you attended, that you had some concerns raised after that, and you requested the board talk about it further.
Okay.
So I think that's, what it was from. That's what Danny told me it was from.
Okay.
Okay.
Are you part of that conference?
Yeah. So, Commissioner, I think it was the issue that you had some concerns regarding that meeting, and some of the things that were said there, that's my understanding, that there's appeared to be some commitment from the county that you weren't aware of, that you had some concerns about.
Oh, it was a total buy-in from everybody, and was my opinion, without seeing the feasibility study or cost benefit analysis, or even the fact that they admitted they'd have to go to legal help to see if they even have the water. And everybody was like, yeah, we're with you.
And that was the county staff you're talking about? Because I recall the discussion we had, obviously we were waiting to see feasibility studies before we decided whether we supported it wholeheartedly or not as a board.
Right.
No, if I remember correctly, there's actually having a document that was submitted by a previous board of the support London project. So the county has already submitted that support early on, prior to these us as commissioners sitting, and prior to the board that I was sitting on, previous to the three of us. So with that being said, the county at Planning Standing had given support to the project, and it was Commissioner Roberts, you were concerned with your fundamental disagreement with the project as an individual, and you wanting to carry forward on as the representative for the county with that project because you have a fundamental disagreement with that, and you believe is in conflict, which that's why I understood it, because you felt that that position that you have is in conflict with the county's position.
And one, we haven't just arrived at as a board.
And I think that the prior board's backing of it was based on what was known then, of course. I guess we have to take a formal difference of opinion on that. We certainly expressed as a board, as I remember, that until we see the feasibility study and report, that full support is not necessarily this board's position.
I don't necessarily disagree with what you're saying, but a board's order carries forward and carries the same weight on this board as any other board. So even though we're not legally bound to maintain the order is in still effect with full support of the county until we make such a decision to rescind this order or to make a new order to change something. So I would submit to this organization board that we are in full support at this board at point in time.
So, Mr. Chair, if I may, so this is the order that Commissioner Bridenbaugh referring to. So this was passed in 2012 was with a board that doesn't have any current board members on it. And under the now their boards. So item number one, the board committee to actively work with our partners and stakeholders to implement the WISE project, including participation on project leadership teams, stakeholder meetings, and public outreach. And we're doing that. I'm the liaison to the WISE project. I'm on those committees and teams. Two, provide funding for a staffing of the WISE coordinator position as county funding allows. And this board.
Where are you reading?
On the first page.
Oh, down below. Okay. Yeah. Sorry, it's off. Okay, great.
So,
thank you.
So providing funding to the coordinator position, that's the $5,000 a year that this board has agreed to do. Number three is collaborate with the WISE partners and stakeholders to ensure grant funding to complete environmental assessment for the project and the EIS. That's underway currently, and so that is underway. Participate in the meeting July 2013. Participate in the WISE community outreach and education activities and provide technical assistance as needed during the EIS phase of the project environmental phase. So that's the level of commitment that this board has provided. There's no funding commitment other than my time. And there's no other additional funding commitment that the board has made towards it. My time and the $5,000 for the coordinator position. Yeah. But other than that, there is no additional think that the board is committed to as far as saying that we're going to help finance the project, fund the project, full support. We're going to have to work with our partners, it says, that's the limit of what they've done. And if that's too much, then clearly the board has that more property to work that.
I'm comfortable with this level of support. Obviously, other than your time, like you say, no financial support, but I do obviously like to see it move forward so we can see that feasibility study and then make a determination at that point whether it's something that we want to fully back, the property going forward. That's my position of it.
Yeah, I would want to see more buyback to the project as well. And as far as being a liaison, and my fundamental disagreement with it, being stakeholders, not landowners, and not many of the people that we directly affected, I have a problem in how it's progressing with the Oregon Solutions team. So if somebody else wants to take that liaison position to make this workable, to get to these building statements, or if John's just going to do it for us.
Okay, and the liaison, specific liaison position is to the WISE project specifically. I wasn't aware that we had any specific liaison to WISE.
So the regular meetings of the steering committee for WISE is the Oregon Solutions process, we convened a meeting in December and needed, there was a liaison role at that point, and that was Commissioner Roberts. Beyond that, there's very little liaison work that's needed. I think it's primarily I go to those meetings and that's about it.
And we did have the $5,000 in actually just paid the invoice for this year, so that was in our budget. But that's been our level of commitment.
Commissioner Roberts, I understand you correctly that you have concern with the Oregon Solutions process and your role in that.
Yes, in this project, yes.
So my question then would be if Harvey or John, that Oregon Solutions project is team is continuing forward. Is there more work to be done with Oregon Solutions piece?
So the Oregon, that was a funded project to the governor's office that did involve Oregon Solutions. They did all that work in 2011 and 2012, and that concluded with that declaration of cooperation that I just handed out that our board signed. And there was one additional commitment they had, is they had a follow-up meeting in December of 15, and that's the meeting that just occurred. I'm not aware that Oregon Solutions is doing any further work at this point, unless something that they could, that something could be refunded. But my understanding is their commitment to the project has ended, and there won't be further involvement with it. That's my understanding.
So there would be more necessity to make any liaison for that time on the subject. Is that what I understand?
That's my understanding. Like I said, that could change. If the legislators or the current governor wants to involve Oregon Solutions some more, I suppose they could, but they're not funded to do so now, and there's no commitments from them currently.
So
I
would just say, as we move forward, then as things surface, we table it as a board.
Discussing.
Bring it to the table, have a discussion, make a stand, one way or another.
I'm sorry, just terminology. I hear tabling and just setting aside, because I understand verbiage tabling, so that's why I was asking.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, fully vetting any future steps or progress being made that we can be aware of. Okay, so let's move on then.
Thank you.